Materialism is not godliness. The true worth of a minister is not the car he drives. It's not the car he lives in. And it's not, the house he lives in. And it's not the crowd in his church. The true value of a minister is his ability to communicate doctrine. They that labor in word, not in miracles. In word and doctrine are the ones to be honored double, not razzmatazz. The true worth of a preacher is not his bank account. If you measure ministry by material possession, you are carnal. There has been a wrong model where gain has been reflected as godliness. But the scripture doesn't say that. The scripture says godliness with contentment. Not godliness with materialism. Godliness with contentment is great gain. For it is certain that we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain we shall take nothing out of this world. He said, O man of God, flee these things. Flee these things. Run away from the things that define your worth based on material acquisition. Flee from it. He said, if not, you will pierce yourself with many sorrows. Flee these things. Flee these things. Be contented. He said, having food and raiment, let us therewith be content. Once you can eat and wear cloth, even if you don't have a house, be happy. Even if you are trekking, no house, no car, you are trekking, but you are loaded with word. Eat food and wear cloth and be happy. I feel like I'm talking to somebody. My yoke is easy, my burden is light. It is certain that we brought nothing into this world, and it is certain that we will take nothing out of this world. Therefore, if our hope is only in this world, we are of all men most miserable. You will be miserable when you start competing with people on cloth to wear, suit to wear, tie to tie, car to drive. You will get tired very soon. You'll be fed up. And if care is not taken, you will even kill yourself. Sit down and listen. Pastors are resigning in great number. Pastors of 8,000 members, pastors of 20,000 members are resigning. Some of them are committing suicide. Why? They have the crowd, they have the money, but the greed has overtaken them. They feel with all that crowd, they need more and they can't get more. So they kill themselves. Greed. Greed has entered the church very quietly, decorated with a term called prosperity. It's greed. You know what I'm talking about. They are resigning. They are killing themselves. Even their children are killing themselves. They are tired. The thing is not working for them the way they think it should work, because they have attributed godliness to materialism. Please, let's sit down. Any man of God that values another man of God on the basis of material things, you are more carnal than those in Galatians. Because a man's life does not consist in the abundance of things that he possesses. Say, I hear you. That's right. We need to fix things right. Our generation cannot afford to mess around, because we are a generation of revelation, accuracy, and preciseness. The true worth of a man of God is word and doctrine. Listen to me. Years after you leave this world, nobody will remember the car you drove. Nobody will remember the house you lived in. And nobody will remember the crowd you commanded. But they will remember your message. Why are we talking about Paul today? Message. Why are we talking about Peter? Message. Why is nobody talking of Judas? Eh? Greed. The only message of Judas is he was a thief. Full stop. There's nothing to preach about Judas. But there's everything to talk about Paul. There's everything to talk about Peter, James. There's everything to talk about John. There's everything to talk because they left for us word and doctrine. Why are we talking about E.W. Kenyon today? Why are we talking about Kenneth Hagin? I've never met Kenneth Hagin. I don't know where he lived. I don't know what car he drove. I don't know what kind of clothes he wore. But I know what he wrote in his books and what I heard in his CDs and what I watch on his video. Until tomorrow, generations will still talk about him because he preached sound word. I'm teaching here.